Hillary Clinton and Barack Obama are pulling out all the stops in an effort to try to win support from the Democratic superdelegates, who will almost certainly wind up deciding the party's presidential nominee. Let's go to Carol Costello. She's looking at this story for us. And you're looking specifically, Carol, at some new efforts to woo those superdelegates that Senator Clinton is engaged in.
Yeah, new efforts that include a little wine, a little cheese, and a charming, informative talk with a Washington power broker. It sounds so Washington. What sets it apart is this was Hillary Clinton's home, and she was doing the talking.
A new weapon in the battle for superdelegates, the cocktail party. While Hillary Clinton and Barack Obama played nice on the Senate floor, Clinton's staff was preparing her Washington home for a party. Among the invited, uncommitted superdelegates.
She gave a very short speech and then stood in the front and said, anything is fair game, ask any questions that you want.
It was an important party for Clinton. She's counting on the superdelegates to vote her to victory at the Democratic National Convention. Right now, she's in the superdelegate lead. Of the 795 superdelegates up for grabs, she has 237 to Obama's 207. 351 superdelegates are uncommitted. Of late, though, Clinton has suffered defections. Georgia Representative John Lewis switched to Obama a few weeks ago. And in the last 3 weeks, Obama has gained the support of 31 superdelegates. Hence the cocktail party. California Congresswoman Susan Davis was also there. For Davis, choosing between the two will be especially tough. In California's February primary, there was just a 1% difference between the two candidates. Davis's concern now is the tone of the Democratic contest, and she shared that with Clinton.
Every campaign's going to have negativity. I think the question that really we can look at is whether it's been of such a nature that it has truly divided the party and you know, frankly, bloodied either one of the candidates.
Congressman Altmire of Pennsylvania will wait to see how his state votes in April. But he asked Clinton why he should vote her way if Obama still leads in the popular vote and in pledged delegates.
If Senator Obama is ahead on all counts, then certainly it would be difficult for me to make a decision to go the other way.
Clinton's response, she feels superdelegates exist for a reason. And that is to exercise independent judgment.
Now, well, both lawmakers told me they found the party informative, helpful. As for whether it swayed their opinion one way or the other, they wouldn't tell me. Back to you, Walt.
All right, Carol, thank you for that. Let's discuss this and more.